Students, I am your new science teacher. My name is Karthik sir. Okay, so we'll continue today with science, page number 10, about characteristics of living beings. So today we are dealing with sixth characteristic of living being. Living beings excrete. So like you will be knowing, I think, there are many activities it takes place in the body, in our body. So like digestion, respiration, all the things. Because of these activities, we get energy. As a result, what happens? There are some unwanted things produced in our body. So these should be thrown out of body. Otherwise, these are like poison. It will affect our body. So, and living things, animals and plants throw unwanted things out of the body. They throw unwanted things in the form of carbon dioxide, sweat, feces, urine, etc. To throw unwanted things out of the body, they have special organism. So plants give out carbon dioxide during respiration. Dry leaf, stem, rotting parts, all are separate, get separated from plants, and plants also release excess water into atmosphere through leaves. So the first 10 characteristics is living beings do excretion. Non-living things don't do excretion. So what is excretion or excrete? The process where we remove unwanted things out of our body in the form of carbon dioxide, sweat, feces and urine is called excretion. Excretion is only done by living things. It is not done by non-living things. Very important. So plants release carbon dioxide as a byproduct, as an excretory product during respiration. The leaf, stem, all and the rotten parts also fall out from the plants, and also plants release excess water also. There is excess water also through the leaves in stomata. So this proves that living things excrete and non-living things will not excrete. Students, understood? So again, I am repeating for you. Living things do excretion. Excretion means throwing waste products out of the body. If these are not thrown out of the body, they will affect our body. Got my point, children? So how do we, in what form we throw or excrete unwanted things of the body? We excrete in the form of carbon dioxide through nose, sweat through skin, feces through anus and urine. These are all some of the forms by which we do excretion in our body. So if you say, now next we are going to living things reproduce. Now look at this picture, children. Now what is common in this picture? In this picture you can see all the organisms are with their young ones. There is a lady, there is cow, there is dog, there is hen, there is duck. There is even lion also. So all organisms are with their young ones or their babies. And if you clearly observe, the young ones of each organism are looking like their parents also, which give birth to them. So if you observe clearly, the young ones look like their parents. The young one looks like their parents. So this process where an organism give birth to young ones which resemble it is called as reproduction. So what is reproduction, children? The process where an organism gives birth to young ones which resembles is called as reproduction. So again I am telling what is reproduction. The process where an organism give birth to young ones which resemble it is called reproduction. Process where an organism gives birth to young ones which resemble it is called reproduction. The process where an organism gives birth to young ones which resemble it is called reproduction. So this is reproduction is done by only living things. It is not done by non-living things. Non-living things cannot reproduce their young ones. Only living things can produce young ones. So here is a table. We will put right or wrong. Organisms continue their generation by reproduction. It is right. It is right. Due to reproduction, the other organisms in environment get food. This is wrong. This is wrong. Reproduction is seen only in animals. Wrong. Reproduction is also seen in plants. There will be not be any danger in the environment by over reproduction of a single organism. Wrong. So there will be danger due to over reproduction in the environment. So once again I'll tell which one is the first one. Organisms continue their generation by reproduction is right. Due to reproduction, the organisms in the environment get food is wrong. Reproduction seen only in animals is also wrong. There will not be any danger in the environment by over reproduction of a single organism is also wrong. Got it, children? You should put right or wrong. Some animals carry out reproduction by laying eggs and some directly give birth to young ones. Some animals carry out reproduction by laying eggs and some other directly giving birth to young ones. Some animals carry out reproduction by laying eggs and some give directly birth to young ones. For example, cow will directly give birth to young ones. But hen lays eggs. From the eggs, young ones come out. These are the two kinds of reproduction in animals. Once again, I am telling children, some animals carry out reproduction by laying eggs. Some other directly give birth to young ones. Write down few animals which give birth to young ones and write down some animals which lay eggs. So there are two columns. So like I told, not only animals, even plants also will do reproduction. Very important. So how do plants do reproduction? Plants do reproduction through seeds and stems. Do reproduction through seeds and stems. Okay, we will discuss about how the plant will reproduce and its life cycle. Seed is an important part in reproduction. Plants produce a new plant with the help of seed. Seed is an important part in reproduction in plants. Seeds, developing from seeds is one of the wonders of nature. Some plants, apart from seeds, produce new plants through stem buds also. So plants reproduce with the help of seed. Seed is the most important reproductive part, which is formed in the flower. Seed producing another seed is one of the wonders of nature. Some plants can also reproduce through stem and buds. We will go for life cycle of a plant. So the seed will produce plant, the plant will produce flower, flower will produce fruit, the fruit will produce seed. So once again, we'll go for life cycle. The life cycle of the plant produces flower, flower produces fruit, fruit produces seed, and seed produces again plant. So once again, very important about life cycle plants. The plant produces flower, the flower produces fruit, the fruit produces seed. Very important. Usually, reproduction takes place in seeds. But in some, it can also take place with the help of stem also. It can take help. Reproduction of plants is advantageous many ways. So reproduction of plants gives an advantage to plants and also animals, because animals get food due to reproduction in plants. If plants would not do reproduction, then animals would not get food. Would do reproduction, animals would not get food. So once again I'll discuss, once again we'll go for this chart. So this chart, organisms continue their generation by reproduction. So living beings, next is living beings respond to stimulus. It's very important. So we learnt now that from first will coming, living beings do excretion. What is excretion? The process where we throw unwanted things out of our body. Non-livings will not do excretion. Next is living things do reproduction. They produce their young ones. Non-living things will not produce their young ones. Things will not produce their young ones. Now next we'll go for living beings respond to stimulus. When thorns prick, we feel pain. Namulchusdaga navagate. Body shiver in cold. Snake hissing in cell divisions. Buffalo getting into water to cool off during exciting heat. Some insects bite when we touch us. So namang mulchuchado nav chaliyada nadagado idella nav enantivi respond to stimulus. It is only found in living things or living beings. Non living things will not respond to stimulus. Animals shout, insects bite, all organisms respond in their own way. All of these are responses given by organisms to the surrounding stimulus. All of these responses were given by organisms to the surrounding stimulus. Stimulus. Living beings respond to changes in their surroundings. Usually they, living beings respond to touch, heat, cold, sound and smell. They have special organs for these. Living beings respond to stimuli. Stimulus means changes in the environment. So like I told, once again I'll be repeating for you. When thorns prick, we feel pain. We shiver in cold. Buffalo go to water when it is cold.
Okay, insects bite, snake hisses when it becomes angry. This is what we call response to stimuli. Non-living things will not respond to stimuli. Only living things will respond to stimuli. So, this is another characteristics of living organisms. Coming from first, living things do excretion. They remove unwanted things out of their body. Living things can do reproduction. They produce their young ones. And living things, last but not least, living things respond to stimulus. Living things respond to heat, cold, touch, pain, everything. So non-living things will not respond to heat, cold, touch, and everything. So it's very important. They have special organs for respond to stimuli. See the picture here. Here, this is touch me plant, touch me not plant. If you touch that plant, it will close itself. This is what response to stimuli. And this is another one, is scorpion. If you touch, it will bite, it will sting. This is also an example to respond to stimulus. Flower, sunflower turning towards sun is also a response to stimulus. This is also an example to stimulus. So, plants and animals both respond to stimulus. Living beings have lifespan. Organisms take birth, become adults, reproduce, become old and die at last. This process between birth and death of an organism is called lifespan. So, living organisms have a lifespan. We die, but non-living things will not die. So, living organisms take birth, become adult, reproduce, become old and die at last. Living organisms take birth, become adults, reproduce, become old and die at last. So we die. This period between birth and death is called lifespan. So the turtle will live up to 150 years, elephant lives up to 70 years, cow lives up to 20 years, eagle lives up to 20 years, man lives up to 70 to 80 years. So living beings have a lifespan. Non-living things will not have lifespan. Based on lifespan, three types of plants: annuals, biennials, and perennials. There are three types of plants based on annuals, biennials, and perennials. So annuals are those which bear flower, produce fruits and die in a year or season. So plants which produce flowers and fruits in 1 year and die are called annual plants. Plants which live up to 2 years or two seasons before producing flower, fruits and seeds and die are called biennials. Plants which live for many years and keep producing flower, fruits and seeds are called as perennials. So once again we'll come. Living beings do excretion. Living beings throw unwanted substances out of the body. They throw unwanted substances in the form of carbon dioxide, sweat, feces, and urine. Plants also will do excretion. Animals also will do excretion. Animals also will do excretion. Living organisms reproduce.
Living organisms give birth to young ones which resemble the parent. So it is called as reproduction. Living beings give birth to young ones which is called as reproduction. Non-living things will not do reproduction. Non-living things will not do reproduction. The young ones of each organism looks like their parents. The process where an organism gives birth to young ones which resemble its parent is called reproduction. Process where an organism gives birth to young ones which resemble the parent is called reproduction. Plants reproduce through seeds and stems. Plant life cycle of plant is seed produces plant, plant produces flower, flower produces fruit, fruit produces seed. See, plant produces flower, flower produces fruit, fruit produces seed, seed produces plant again. This is the life cycle of plant. Seed is the most important part in reproduction. One seed will produce a plant which produces flower, fruit and seed again, which is the wonder of the world. One seed produces plant, the plant produces flower, flower produces fruit, and fruit produces seed. Living beings respond to stimulus, touch, heat, cold, pain, everything. Example, when thorns prick, we feel pain, body shivers in cold. Buffaloes go to water when it is hot. Insects bite us. These are some of the examples of respond to stimuli. Living things respond to stimuli. Non-living things will not respond to stimuli. Things respond to stimuli and non-living things will not respond to stimuli. Very important. So, living organisms shows to stimuli, non-living things will not respond to. Living things have birth and death. Non-living things will not die. They wear out. Turtle lives for 150 years. Elephant lives for 70 years. Cow lives for 20 years. Eagle lives for 20 years. Man lives for 70 years. Based on life plants, three kind of plants are there. Plants which produce seeds, fruits and seeds for one season and die are called annuals. Plants which live up to 2 years are called as biennials. Plants which live for many years are called perennials. Very important. Plants which live for many years are called perennials. Plants which live for 2 years are called biennials. So once again we'll turn. So today's homework is you should write all the characters of living organisms. So in textbook nearby, all living characteristics are there. They move, they excrete. You should write all the characteristics of living organism without even missing one also. So what all characteristics today we discussed? Today we discussed living beings excrete, living beings reproduce, living beings respond to stimuli, living beings have lifespan. These all you should write in your homework book and give some examples. So once again I'm telling homework, living beings excrete, living beings reproduce, living beings respond to stimuli, living beings have lifespan, living beings have lifespan. So these are some of the characteristics of living things. These are some of, that is the homework. And also you should write this box you should put right or wrong, that's all. This box, as I told, you should put right or wrong. So try to write even the characteristics of living beings which was explained earlier also. Write characteristics of living beings which were explained earlier also. And also write this life cycle of plant. Write life cycle of plant. This is also homework. And write this table. This is also homework. So homework. This is also homework. So once again I'll tell all the characters of living things which you should write in homework. Living things excrete, living beings reproduce, living beings respond to stimulus, living beings have lifespan. So this all you should write, and you should write this table also. Before writing this table, you should write this also, this life cycle of plant. And before this, you should also write this table. Just write right or wrong, put tick mark, right or wrong you should write. Right, and once telling not to miss homework. So I am your new science teacher called Karthik sir. So I will be checking the homework. Without miss, should do homework. Should only write homework neatly. So once again, living things excrete, living things respond to stimulus, they reproduce, they have lifespan. Things they respond, they have reproduce. Please reproduce. Don't miss homework. Okay, don't miss homework. Living things, two type animals reproduce by two methods. One, though they lay eggs, and also they give birth to young ones. Plants reproduce through seeds and stems.